messages from Transformers Chapel, the altar at which lives are transformed and altered.
Remember what Moses said to Joshua and the children of Israel. Be not afraid, fear not, and be not dismayed.
Sit back and listen. Be inspired and blessed.
The most destructive enemy or element in human mind is fear.
This message is from Pastor David Adjoye.
Tell your neighbor, get physical strength. What are the anchor scriptures? Read them out. Let me hear you one. Do you know the meaning of that? You know the meaning of great, amen? What about physical strength? Physical strength. Do you have physical strength?
Amen.
You know spiritual strength? And you know physical strength. We need to talk about this because without physical strength, you can't still fulfill destiny. That's why God wants your body to be empowered. Jesus was empowered in his spirit, in his soul, amen, full of wisdom, and in his body. We were never told that he was down with sickness, but he was dying. Know what I said in that Hebrews chapter 10 verse 5, he said, a body had not prepared me. A body has not prepared me means you have prepared my body to suit your purpose. Somebody who will be a deliverer will not have a weak body. What will he tell people? And then 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 23 says, he said, the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. Holistic sanctification. And I pray God, your whole spirit, soul, and body be preserved. Spirit, soul, and body be preserved. So man is three in one. He's a spirit. He has a soul and he lives in a body. And these three areas of his life must be empowered. Now you can imagine, if your spirit is strong, your soul is wonderful, but your body is weak. You can imagine if he's a preacher. Yeah, his soul is, he knows the Bible, he prays very well, he's connected, but he can't, he's like a vegetable, you know, the body. You know, if they bring him here, he's doing like this, you won't even listen. Are you getting me? Praise God. You see the body? So he will still make it. And if this three area of his life is empowered, oh my God, he will go very far. You can imagine you're a Christian, filled of the Holy Spirit. You can actually point to witches and judge. He said, you're a witch, stand up. You're a wizard. God told me yesterday. Are you getting me? And then he has a business in town. Yeah, he's hospitalized. Can he run that business? So man must have his entire life sanctified. Praise God. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 16. That he would grant you according to the riches of his glory to be strengthened with might. Amen? By the Spirit in the inner man. To be strengthened with what? Might. Samson was full of might. That he can take the whole gate of a city and take it to the mountain. Might. Praise God. Colossians 1:11. Strengthened with all might, according to his glorious power, unto all patience and long suffering with joy. So, sickness is not of God, okay? Sickness is a rope of destiny. Sickness is a satanic device to distract you, to distract your attention from your destiny. You can't be sick and attend to your destiny. Your destiny, you know, demands your full attention in order to take it to the glorious place where God wants it to be. Are you getting what I'm saying? But if you are sick, you are completely distracted. Sickness is a distraction. And of course, God doesn't distract people. It's only the devil that distracts people away from their destiny. Praise the Lord. Amen. Satan has an agenda. And one of the agenda he has is poverty, sickness, to make sure people don't get there. Sickness can terminate a glorious destiny if you don't check it on time. That's why you have to fight. Any mosquito you see is like war. You declare war. You want to bite me? No, I'll finish you myself. Because if that mosquito gets you, can inject malaria into your body. And that malaria can turn haywire. Are you getting me? And may manipulation not come, that they will manipulate the doctors to give you the wrong drug that will kill you. God forbid. You will be a victim of wrong medication. Can I hear your amen? Do you know some people have died because of that? It's only in Africa we go to doctors. That's why you have to. It's better not to be sick. You understand? Because, you see, I see sickness as a risk. You got to be going to the doctor, it's a risk. Because, you see, you have to follow what they say. If they say, go and take this gallon of liquid, you have to take. Are you getting me? And you don't know whether they are giving you wrong. We have seen where they gave wrong medication that has now damaged other organs beyond repair. I fear going to doctors because they are human. And every human being is prone to errors. You think I can't make a mistake. People make mistakes. No matter how professional you are, you can still blunder. Have you not heard where they forgot scissors inside of the mouth? They forgot what one woman, you know, that had been having problems for so many, like 6 years. They forgot what they put inside her when they operated her. One woman happening history, they forgot scissors. One tiny scissors that is inside. And the woman was going through a excruciating pain. For years, scissors. Can you imagine? And I'm sure it's the devil, it's manipulation, because when she was going through prayer, they went to check, they didn't see anything. Until when prayer was offered, and went to the hospital and they discovered that. All kinds of things happen in this world. Even Michael Jackson, I got it was overdosed. The doctor gave, I think the doctor was proceeding. You remember? I don't know whether he has been jailed. No, he must have been dead perhaps. That man wouldn't have died. He gave, you know, overdose of a doctor. And that's a doctor in America. What up the money for Ambari? Doctor in Ambari, I'll bet you that is going to die. May you not be a victim of doctors. Yeah. All doctors in this house, you will prosper, but not from transformers. From unbelievers who are out there. I used to tell God that, look, or myself, if my body is weak and I see an unbeliever smoking, I'm going like this on the street, it's an insult. How can I be sick and an unbeliever is smoking and going? I said, no, that that sickness, go! And miss that guy. I don't care where he's coming from. Is it an amusement? A child of God, fill of the Holy Ghost. And then one believer is smoking, he's drinking. That's all come here. Ha! No! That sickness should go 100 times and meet that person. Leave my body.
Praise God.
That's the kind of mentality I use in delivering myself. For 30 years I've been bathing like stone. Amen. Amen. So sickness is a robber. It robs you of your time. And you know you need time because time is the raw material for the production of success. So time wasted is success forbidden.
Praise God.
So you can see that sickness is not good. So we need to fight it. And that's what we're doing this week. We'll be telling you how you live your life so that you can live healthy. So that you can be strong mentally, bodily, and otherwise to be strong and healthy. Because the journey is far. Amen. And you need your body. No matter how your spirit is, you still need a strong body to drive you through life. That's what I've presented today. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And may the Lord give you physical strength. May the Lord give you physical strength. May the Lord give you physical strength. You know, the good thing about God is that He has assured us of healing. I will restore health unto you. Jeremiah 37:17. Jeremiah 33:6 says, I'm going to cure your sickness. Jeremiah 33:6 says, I'm going to cure. I will bring health and cure. And I will cure them. Amen. Who forgiveth thee of thy iniquities? Who healeth all thy diseases? Psalm 103:3. So, God heals all manner of sickness. The one that orthodox drugs cannot handle, God can handle it. Are you getting me? You know there are some sickness that don't have an orthodox solution. No medical solution. A God can deliver you. It's only God who heals. And I made a statement in the first service that good health is not a natural phenomenon. Good health is not what? It is a supernatural phenomenon. That's very supernatural. For somebody to say that. Praise the Lord. I remember we forgot to tell them that this Wednesday is going to be healing service. Say amen.
Amen.
Anyone you know that needs a touch from heaven, cases that have defied medical solution, bring them here.
Amen.
So, our Wednesday and Friday will be healing school. Say, will be healing school.
Mm-hmm.
I heard one like that, and one has been in hospital for about 2 months. They told me, it's like this. They drip the thing blows back. For 2 months, going through excruciating pain. So they brought him in a stretcher. To the healing school. After the anointing, the stomach went flat. And that was the end of that problem. Do you know that there are some plague that actually are orchestrated from the realm of the spirit? It's an arrow shot at someone. And such things, microscope cannot detect it. MRI cannot see it. Because it is spiritual. Praise God. How strange is happening in this world? Strange things. And I believe that anyone that is under that satanic oppression, God is going to deliver them in our days.
Yeah.
Can I hear your
amen?
So Wednesday and Friday, will handle that. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
One man was stealing blood. They thought it was just ordinary stealing blood. Went to the hospital, was admitted for 1 week. They were giving him drips. He was stealing, and the thing continued. So he said, no, take me to the pastor. So he came to my office. It was not a service day. He came to the office. And he told me, I said, they have carried all the tests. They couldn't see anything. There's nothing. Absolutely nothing. It was strange. And I did something straight. I said, okay, this is inside. Let me put something inside you. See, I'm looking for the inside here. You know what? I told him. He went and excreted a snail. And that was the end of that bleeding. Any death that has been programmed inside any man, God will flush it out. He said, anything which my father had not done shall be rooted out. Can somebody shout amen? So God can take care of both physical or physiological problems. Are you hearing me? And spiritual problems. That's spiritual, but the doctors cannot handle it. They can't handle it. The physical one, they are trying. Even the physical one, they are yet to find a solution to all of them. Isn't it?
Hope you enjoyed, touched, and blessed to your next level. Worship with us at Transformers Chapel. We are situated on Kilimani Road, Elsie Plaza, Ofeligeo Marakwet, Adams Arcade Roundabout. Visit us on our website, www.transformerschapel.org, or our Facebook page, Transformers Chapel, Nairobi.